IBERS is a brand new institute formed by the merger of IGA, a BBSRC institute, with two university departments to create a vigorous new hybrid. IBERS is very much focused on the big challenges facing society, the 21st century grand challenges that include food security, climate change and biodiversity. So we are very much involved in translational research, in translating basic scientific discoveries and reducing them to practice. And for example, we have major public good plant breeding programs which are geared towards the food security agenda and mitigating the effects of a changing climate.
Well, the Biorenewables team focuses very much on plant sciences and using particular plants like Miscanthus, ryegrass and willow, and how we can use those to best mitigate climate change. For example, we can use biomass, we can burn it, and that can generate energy and heat. But the other alternative is to take that biomass and use it to make chemicals that can be then used in a series of industrial processes. For example, you can make potentially bioplastics from grass, or a whole series of organic acids that are used in everyday goods like, for example, plastics, pharmaceuticals, biocomposites.
Miscanthus is a biomass crop. It has very high yields. It's a tropical crop, but unlike its close relatives, it tolerates low temperatures, so it's ideal crop for temperate zones like the UK. On the whole, we have two types of Miscanthus. Some have a small number of very strong, thick stems, and others have a very large number of very fine stems. And we need to understand how we can breed those together to give an optimal stem number and stem thickness for the type of biomass that we need.
Well, the crops that we grow here at IBERS, for example, the grasses and the Miscanthus, the aim is to grow those on more marginal land. We don't intend to compete with the production of grain that is grown on high quality arable land. So the two activities should be cooperative, and there should essentially be no competition for land use either as a biofuel or for the production of grain.
Biomass is a renewable form of either liquid transport fuels or other chemicals. So instead of digging up fossil fuels that have sequestered carbon underground for millions of years, we're only using the carbon dioxide that was taken up by the plant as it grew. So in that sense, we're not contributing to atmospheric carbon dioxide. And in fact, if we can get the plants to sequester carbon underground in their roots, then we're actually taking carbon out of the air at the same time as we're generating high-value products.
So we have a multidisciplinary approach to plant breeding at IBERS. This includes breeding programs for renewable energy with Miscanthus. We have major breeding programs for oats together with ryegrass. And in each of these, we are interested in public good. So in other words, we're interested in producing plants that reduce the environmental footprint of agriculture and, for example, with ryegrass, reduce the methane emissions that come from livestock. So we have major programs, for example, looking at developing new grass varieties that result in increased live weight gain for livestock, but also reduce greenhouse gas emissions. So we're really looking for win-wins between food security via public good plant breeding and reducing environmental footprints. We see plant breeding as a major technology platform that doesn't recognise borders. So we have a very strong international perspective on plant breeding. We're involved in training plant breeders, and our work on pearl millet in India is a good example of where we're using the expertise that exists in IBERS to work with colleagues in India to produce pearl millet, which is resistant to various pests and pathogens. We employ over 300 people. We have about 1,000 undergraduates, more than 100 postgraduates, and we're located in Aberystwyth in Wales. Our total turnover is around 25 million. Approximately 16 million is research and enterprise based, and 8 million is associated with our education programs. Our focus in the future is going to be to invest both in terms of the competencies and skills together with the infrastructure to ensure that Aberystwyth is an international centre for food, water and energy security, and ensure that we can make a major contribution to the challenges that are facing society in the 21st century.